This is Dave. I have a pretty long list of, well, not long, but it's a list now. It's a list with more than five, but it's a list with names of games that I've been meaning to talk about. And I'm usually late to the party on pretty much all games. So out of that list, I guess I'm now going to talk about Watch Dogs, which is a game I played, it's not actually recently. I mean, feels recently. It was about a couple of months ago. But I didn't make a video immediately after I played it. So this is why I have a list. Going down the list, I mean, I can just kind of name some games that I meant to really talk about, but I'm going to be very, very late in talking about them. The Last of Us, not the remastered version because I played on the PlayStation 3. I don't have a PS4. The Last of Us, I just recently played Ratchet & Clank Into the Nexus. I'm playing Mass Effect right now, the first one. And it's a game that I played quite some time ago, when it was actually first released, but on my friend's Xbox 360. Right now, I'm playing it on my PlayStation 3, and I'm going through a second playthrough. So revisiting this game after so many years is interesting. And a whole bunch of other games that I want to talk about. But this video, I want to talk about Watch Dogs. So Watch Dogs is a... I'm not really going to get into a lot of the history behind it. You know, it's a game that had a lot of hype behind it. Like, it was... You know, I think I was sucked into it, too, when I first kind of saw its E3 unveil. And it was just like, wow, you can kind of... It's an open-world game with... You could use your phone as a weapon. And you could use kind of... That was an interesting concept. And the graphics were wild. I was running on a PC, of course. When it released, graphics was toned down a bit. And I played on the PlayStation 3, so graphics department doesn't even matter that much to me. Because otherwise, you know, it's a ported down, whatever. But that's usually the whole graphics thing is not of interest to me. I mean, I'm still playing on a PS3. I still play Wii from time to time. And sometimes I'm still on my iPhone 4 and iPad and 3DS and PSP. So whatever, you know, I game all kinds of things. What I'm really interested about is kind of the ideas behind it, the mechanics, the story, the content, and how I can engage with it, what it makes me think about, what it makes me feel. And Watch Dogs, there's a lot of interesting things that it's just like, you know, and before I even played Watch Dogs, was also interesting. I read this spoof script of the game. So I forget the name of the site, but if I remember it, I'm going to link it to the video description. But there is a website that's kind of has video game stories, not too many of them, but he's wrote a script of the story of the video game stories, but making fun of them. So these are like fourth wall breaking kind of scripts. So I really liked his one on the Splinter Cell Blacklist. I think Blacklist, no, not Blacklist, but the one before that, the what was it, Covert something, the one before Blacklist was Splinter Cell that, I think it was Conviction, actually, yeah. So he wrote a script, like, kind of, with characters saying, like, weird, kooky things. So I read Watch Dogs script before I even played it, and it was just really funny, like, kind of the things. But for what it's worth, I think story of Watch Dogs is... It's pretty interesting. I'm not going to get into the story at this point. There'll probably be another video, maybe part two or part three, however long I end up talking about Watch Dogs. So I certainly think there are a lot of things to talk about Watch Dogs. Like the history, the disappointment, whatever, that I think that's pretty much been covered by everyone who ever talked about Watch Dogs. I'm not here to really review Watch Dogs, but just to say there are some... The mechanics of Watch Dogs I thought was... there are some... In some ways, like, I was, like, so... I found Watch Dogs to be, like, a very well-designed game in regards to some mechanics. And it's just, like, I wish, wow, I wish this wasn't, like, every other kind of open-world games like this in Grand Theft Auto and whatnot. But I do think a lot of disappointment stems from the fact that it's a game that kind of was marketed as, like, oh, this is such a brand-new, awesome game concept. But when you actually get down to playing it, you're going to be driving... For the majority of it, that in that way it feels very much like the other kind of open world games like Saints Row and Grand Theft Auto, and there are so many other kind of open world games now. But it feels like that, and it's very combat heavy. Regarding combat, I think it's Watch Dogs. It feels so good, the combat. the gunfight. You know, you stick behind cover, and it's kind of it's very kind of a natural cover system, I thought, to in my opinion. Although, like, kind of selecting weapons around is kind of a pain. But you have all these weapons, and each enemy that can kind of pop to you is a real threat. You can die from any of the enemies. You know, you don't have, like, this ridiculous health bar that you don't understand. I think a lot of the problems with the Grand Theft Auto games is you have a health bar that it's kind of hard to understand. The newer ones, actually, you know, GTA 4 and GTA 5 and whatnot. San Andreas had a very clear health bar, but even so, that was very an arcade-y type of experience. And then I think Vice City had kind of the percentage system or whatever with the armor and whatnot. And so I really like the combat of Watch Dogs, although it does feel like there's too much of it. It's a game that is gets extremely violent and gunplay wise. Not to say that's wrong, but it feels out of place sometimes. Almost like, just God, how many guys do I have to mow down at this part? How many guys have to shoot up? You know, and it is Aiden Pierce, like, hacking genius, or what kind of military combat experience does he have to like just that? But that's a typical video game concern when you have these kind of games, like Uncharted, for example. You're mowing down waves and waves of highly trained enemy soldiers, guerrilla soldiers, no less, too. So, and it's just like, wow, like, that's crazy. At the end of the game, you have a body count of up to 1,000, and Aiden Pierce is no different in that regard. So that's very interesting. But there are a lot of things about Watch Dogs that I really really like. The having to spawn, being able to spawn a vehicle from anywhere, pretty much. Using your phone, like, really awesome concept. Instead of having to, you know, the previous GTA games, you had to, like, find a parking spot to save your vehicle, which is a really dumb concept, if you ask me, because once you use a vehicle in these open world games, the car's gonna get beat up, and you're gonna end up with a new one anyway. So really interesting stuff, and the kind of the checkpoint system that they have was really cool. Kind of the way it kind of, there are little nuances here and there with this open world design that I really really like, and I would hope that it's applied in other kind of open world games. And having all weapons too, like I think that's pretty typical of many open world games, but it's quite nice to have so much variety of weapons and gadgets at your disposal, and to be able to craft them, to have a skill system in which you can kind of determine what kind of skills do what, and how you accrue skills is really interesting too. And it's based on kind of earning experience points, doing missions, and there are some skills that you unlock by doing specific things. Very few though. And so overall, like, and it's a game just with a lot of content. I didn't really do the whole full completion, but in some ways there's too much content that's kind of filler content. You know, it's just like, oh yeah, this vehicle contracts, there's 40 of them. Oh yeah, the briefcase contracts, there's 15 of them. You just go around hacking into people's phones and witnessing, and then going to drive. There's a lot of driving in this game that is just kind of really too much. And in the game like this where it's killing civilians is, you know, you have that meter in which you are, you know, your wanted level, I suppose, in this game. And it feels so bad, you know. In a Grand Theft Auto game, like, it's civilians are just fodder, just whatever. They're in your way because it doesn't really match up with the character. You just whatever, you know. But having Aiden Pierce just mow down civilians by accident because I'm driving and there's driving things that happen, it feels very odd. But I think, and this, I'll get into this in the next video, kind of Aiden Pierce as a character, I think that to me brought a lot of thoughts. You know, I had to reflect a lot on that. Aiden Pierce as a video game character. And before I get into the next video, I guess I'll just sum it up in this way. Aiden Pierce is a psychopath or a sociopath, like the very clinical definition of it. That is my conclusion of this character. And that is a very interesting way to kind of to frame the story that happens with Watch Dogs, I think. But I'll talk more about that in the next video.